William, isn't it? He likes the best, and he usually gets it. But not always.
I didn't realize he was this successful.
He took us all by surprise, actually. Did you know? We started out together. We were roommates in the city. Poorest church mice, auditioning for everything that came along. And then one day out of the blue, he says, "You know, I think I'll write a play about Sherlock Holmes." And then I said, "Don't be ridiculous, that'll never work." And then he writes a play and stars in it for 20 years, and here we are.
Oh, I know he admires me tremendously.
Does he?
Well, well, well. If it isn't the heiress of Brooklyn.
Hello.
Do you know? I've been thinking about what happened to you. Pretty young actress, no money. Meets eligible young man who's very rich. He falls deeply in love with her, marries her, and promptly dies on the honeymoon. And I think to myself, you must be the luckiest girl in the entire world.
Sorry, she lost her husband, for heaven's sake.
Please, husbands are a dime a dozen. Come and go like ducks around the country pond. They waddle around looking self-important. They quack as if somebody is actually listening to them. And then, mercifully, they die off and disappear.
I think we should go now.
Okay, bye-bye.
That was very endearing of you, Daria. Why not just take an axe and chop her feet off?
Oh, grow up. A little gold digger hit the jackpot. What more does she want? A trophy? She got Simon in the bargain, too. Let's stop talking about them. Let's talk about me instead. What is it that you like most about me?
Your shyness.
I like you because you're handsome and stoic. Doesn't all of Gillette's success make you on his screen? Aren't you seething with jealousy on the inside?
No, he's my best friend.
Really? Then you didn't try to shoot him?
How could I? I was on stage when he got shot.
So was everyone else who's here this weekend. Except dear innocent Martha.
And you?
Why would I want to shoot him? I haven't slept with him yet. Now stop being stoic and kiss me.
I'm a married man.
Oh, so that means your lips don't work at all anymore?
Daria!
Oh, Felix, 10 minutes. Upstairs, you'll never miss us.
Daria!
Oh, Felix, we never get to spend any time together.
We could be spending a great deal of time together. In there, eating dinner.
You're upset about the review, aren't you?
You did call me a side of beef.
But in a nice way. Oh, Felix, I was just trying to get a laugh. I should tell the truth when I write, shouldn't I? Truth and beauty, as the poet Shelley said, is all we know on earth and all we need to know.
Keats.
Huh?
The poet's name is Keats.
Oh, you're even more attractive when you stand up to me.
I should get back to the
other. Oh, surely not yet.
Sorry, sorry, no!
Felix! There are certain things that I know about your past that you may not want banning amongst your loved ones. It may be in your best interest to be a little nicer to me, don't you think?
You would.
A wonderful dinner.
Oh, it really was. Yes, Esther.
Finish drink, master of the rebels. Stir up the Athenian youth, commandant. Bring forth the pert and nimble spirit of youth.
I shall turn melancholy forth to funerals. Now let's get out some cards and play some bridge.
I will pineapple.
Charades.
Dancing.
Oh, come, come. I have an idea that's better than all those things put together.
I'll give you a hint. It involves shimmering images.
Oh, Willie, here he goes again.
You've got a screen room like they do in Hollywood.
Good guess, but no.
A slideshow.
A walk in the moonlight.
I like it, but unlikely under the circumstances.
Lily, what is it? You're so aggravating.
Well, What do you say
to a seance?
A seance?
Yes. Where churchyard yawn and hell itself breathes forth contagion unto this world.
So this is where we hold hands and talk to the dead?
Incidentally, we don't say dead over, we say passed over.
Or we say lunatic head of acting company forces guests through traumatic evening.
Are you really the believer?
Yes. Sorry. Well, that is, I'm getting to be one. Sir Arthur, he's the one that got me into it. He is quite fanatical about it.
Don't we need a medium or something?
Yes! A medium we do indeed, Simon.
And it just so happens we happen to have the best in the business with us here tonight. Daria.
I knew it! I knew you were up to something!
I'm warning all of you that I take this very seriously.
Well, when did you...
Well, I've been a medium since I was 15. I was staying with my aunt, uncle, and Ferris. They were in grief over the loss of their daughter, my cousin Clements, and the family dabbled in these sort of things, and so one evening they included me in their ceremony. They were having no luck reaching Clements when suddenly, without any warning, she started speaking through me, through my lips.
That must have hurt.
Oh, it was exhilarating.
But why have a seance tonight? I mean, contacting.
Guesses. Nogs.
Dear old Nogs,
but why?
Because, dear boy, he must have overheard something in one of the dressing rooms. The plot to kill Gillette, presumably. So, if he tells us what he saw or heard, or the name of the man who slit his throat, then the mystery is solved. Am I right?
Exactly.
So that means they're going to hear the suspects?
Oh, no. Not at all. Why, you could say it was the understudy or the wardrobe mistress.
Or my Anthony!
All right, well, let's get started. Daria?
The table. That'll be our center, our portal. So everyone bring a chair.
Incidentally, you had a call this afternoon from a young woman named Hamilton?
Oh, no.
Is there a problem?
No. Well, she used to be a friend of mine, a girlfriend, actually. She knows I'm married now, but persists in coming. It's crazy.
Is she unstable?
No, I don't think so. I hope not.
Well, does Maggie know about it?
I guess, since she understands it's not my fault. At least I think she does.
I believe we're ready.
Oh, good. What shall we do?
Everyone, come take a seat around the table. Anywhere you please, take a seat around the table.
Of the other persons at this table. Look at your friends, where they're sitting, and how they look. Good. Now, I'm going to lower the lights, and I want each of you to take a long, slow, deep breath.
I'm beginning to feel creepy already.
You are creepy already.
Quiet. Now I'm going to put some music on just to calm things down. The mood in the room is very important. Let the mood relax you. enter your bodies slowly and deeply.
I could get used to this.
Does it always work? I mean, are you always successful in reaching someone?
Oh, not at all. Quite the contrary. All we can do is create a proper atmosphere and hope that someone from the other side will want to join us.
We can serve drinks.
My contact is a young actress who was murdered by her husband in 1820 in London. He thought she was committing adultery with a leading man.
Life imitates art.
Isn't that comforting?
No. Put your hands on the table, fingers touching.
My name is Bobbio! I'm sorry, I couldn't help it. Sorry.
Lorenzo, are you there? Lorenzo, here. This is Daria. Would you come and visit us? Lorenzo, I think you'll like this visit. You'll be doing someone a big favor.
Simon, stop fooling around!
It wasn't me!
Is that you, Lorenzo?
I've got a bad feeling about this.
Oh, don't be a baby!
I'm telling you this is a bad idea!
Will you two be quiet? Lorenzo, thank you for coming. We deeply appreciate it. Now, Lorenzo, listen carefully. Someone named Nod, the stage doorman at the Palace Theater, was recently murdered. And we are hoping that you can bring him here to us tonight so we can ask him some questions. Are you willing to help us? Thank you, darling. Is there anything you would like us to do?
One of us.
Well, not exactly.
suspicions.
Look, I'm sorry, old man.
Don't touch me, idiot!
Oh, darn.
Don't speak to me! Oh, well, excuse me! But someone is trying to murder me! And I'd like to stop them before it's too late!
Bad girls, he called them.
The malicious ones. They pretended like they knew things because they were insecure.
Insecure?
They bullied people who were afraid of them, and they spread rumors and lies because they were unpopular.
Get out! Get out! Get out, you old hag! And just remember, I'm going to ruin your son! He will be the laughing stock of the entire profession! Now just leave me alone!
Daria? I just want to say again that I had nothing to do with that travesty. I joked around, yeah, and I teased you a little. But you shouldn't blame me.
Stop the blittering. I know what you're up to. You are scared to death. You want all of them to think you're just an idiot.
But I am just an idiot.
Get out!
This shouldn't affect anything that we got.
Get out!
Don't speak, not a word. Just listen. Now, as someone who is once your friend, regardless of our little mistake, I want you to know that this entire display of yours is uncalled for, and I suggest that you apologize to everyone immediately before something untoward happens.
Untoward?
Unexpected. Unfortunate. Now, take my advice. You may not think that I'm your friend, but I am.
Felix, get back here. Felix, I'm talking to you. Felix!
I'm sorry. I meant to leave this with you earlier, and I took it with me by mistake.
Is everyone in this house insane?
Now. Well, that's not very understanding.